Yo,
you. Whoa.
Oh.
Stay down.
Whoa.
Oh.
You're wearing a LeBron James shirt from 2008, bitch.
You don't even go.
Get out of my
face. You don't
face.
Go to Louisiana State.
Yeah, right, Louisiana State Tiger.
Dude, shut the get that shirt out of my face from kindergarten. Jesus Christ.
These are like from Spy Kids. So yeah.
Alright, let's pull up, let's go. At casual.
I don't know if this is casual, let's practice real quick.
Alright. So Mark just told me he's on his way to come lift. He's running right now. We're gonna go give him an early pickup.
Good. Let's do it. There he is. Mark!
I need some rocky background music for this one.
Dude, I brought no phone.
Oh my God.
What? What? So today I'm gonna be showing you guys my full workout. I usually split this up into two segments, one later on in the day and then one earlier. We kinda ran short on time. We're heading out to SAC tonight, so we need to make sure we get it all done now. So today we are hitting back and buys, all of our push-ups, our ab workout, and a little bit of cardio too. It's gonna be a total of a 3-hour workout. I wanna show you guys every single part of it. Stay tuned.
There are a large amount of bees now in my gym, and they're all living right up there. So that's not hot, they're all right there.
So this is my first workout for my back exercise. Right now we're just doing normal seated rows. You wanna make sure you're going slow, contracted, and holding it at the back. Right now we're gonna be doing 12 to 15 reps or anywhere kind of from our max rep range because we already did 3 sets of 8. And I already told you guys I'm kind of done cutting. I'm kind of doing this like slow, lean bulk. So I'm doing 3 sets of 8, 4 set, 12 to 15 reps. So that's what we're doing right here. This is my 4th set, and we're gonna move on to our next exercise. Just ready. I'll show you guys good form. Make sure your feet are planted. 13. That was a brutal one. So now that we finished our rows, we're gonna be moving on to, I mean, the order I do this in doesn't really matter. I don't know exactly what I wanna do next though, I'm trying to think. Okay, so now we're gonna be doing straight arm pull downs. I just filmed this set a second ago, but the camera SD card was full, so I just gotta refill it. So right now, we're just gonna be doing 8 sets. This is my 3rd set. No, why are you saying sets and reps? We're gonna be doing 8 reps. This is now my 3rd set. So after this set, I'm gonna go to my 12 to 15 that we were talking about before. Just a straight arm pull down, arms wherever you want, essentially. Butt out and just come down for 8 reps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Set that. And then again, 4 sets gonna be 12 to 15. For those last couple sets, you really wanna focus on time under tension. So you wanna go slow. We wanna make sure you're repping out and get that max volume you can to get that lasting pump. Basically, what we're doing now are, look, you don't even know what to call these. They're called like the Arnold something. They're basically the lat pull downs, but it's close grip. So it's the same, so right now we're using the exact same grip we use for the seated rows, except we're gonna do pull downs with that. So it's a close grip pull down, and this is an awkward kind of stance. There's nothing really keeping my knees on the floor because I'm a light guy. So what I do is when I hold this here, I put my foot right up against this bar here, right here. So it keeps me, I guess, stationary on the floor, and I'm not moving up. And I keep 1 foot planted, and I come down with the break rep. So 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was actually a little light, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go up weight. I'm gonna hit that 8 again. Because when you, let's say you mess up on a weight, right? You shouldn't count it as your set, right? You want to give in your full potential, your maximum effort. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna race that set. I'm gonna go again with more weight, hit 8 reps, and then I'll move on to my 4th set when I hit my 13, 15. Because that was my 3rd set right there. We gotta go back. So let's hit it again. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. This is the last workout we have for back. I'm doing this one out here because when you're up there on the gym area, it has kind of like a downhill kind of slope to it. So when I'm doing free weight exercises like this, I find myself either falling back on my heels or quite the opposite, I'm coming forward on my toes because I keep flipping around, trying to find that right spot. And either way, I'm always feeling off balance. So I like to do it right here on the grass. And what we're doing right here is just normal rows with the bar. Coming from here, I like to do a reverse grip from here. And it's just, again, 8 reps like that. This is my 3rd set, like the rest. The 4th will be 12 to 13, I'll take off the 10s. This one you want to go slow and just feel that tension like we talked about. So, play some music. Again, this is my last set. This is my last back workout. It's my 4th workout now. Come up here. I like to get adjusted first. Find that back spot. That concludes our back workout. I'm sorry about that. My SD card actually got full and you guys had to delete some stuff. So this is my last workout for back. Then we'll go into our 4 workouts for biceps. Then we'll hit our push-ups, our abs, and we'll run. Yeah, this is a long day. I'm tired, and you guys probably are too. I got 1 set left here. We're gonna do the 12 to 13. Move on to biceps. Let's do it. The only thing different about this bicep workout we're talking about right now is that the hammer curls, right? I only have 30 pounds here, so I don't have that much weight. I usually, especially if I'm ape repping, I'll either go up to 50 or I'll stick to 45. So since I only have 30, my hammer curl exercises, because I think hammer curls are essential, so I can't just substitute it or rotate it for something else. I like to just stick to max, to reps till failure. So for all 4 sets, it's till failure. It usually stops around 30-ish, 15 on each arm, so we do that right now. So grab these here, play some music for you guys. So again, you want to make sure, especially when you're doing hammy curls, you want to make sure your elbow is not coming up with it. It's not a shoulder raise, right? You want to make sure it's staying down, just smooth. 7, 8, 9, 30, just like that. I've been showing you guys 3 sets for every single one of these back workouts. I showed you the 4th set there because, like I said, it was reps till failure anyways, and regardless of what set I did, it was gonna be the same thing every time. So now that we're done with hammer curls, we're either gonna move on to regular curls, barbell curls, or do preacher curls with the machine. I guess you'll just see what we do next. Okay, so I know not everybody has these at their house or at the gym they go to. And hopefully you have this at the gym you go to, but not everybody has it at their house. I'm gonna show you guys something. This is pretty simple here. Sorry, I got pretty much on the treadmill here. But normal preacher curls, hold it from here, grip, boom, just like that. Your tricep against the, the padding, if you wanna call it. 8 reps here. This is my 3rd set. fourth set would be 12 to 13. We'll take off some weight. I don't know if that camera can see down here, but it's free weight down here. You need to stack plates. It's a really cool machine if you're looking to get one for your house. It actually came with this entire Smith machine package. It was like all one deal. It's right here. Go for eight. Make sure you're planted with your feet and you're not coming up off the ground, right? Have enough weight to be stable, but also get a good pump for that tension. All right, so let's do it. Let's do eight. Like that, on to the next workout. Now we got barbell curls. This is the third workout of this bicep routine. This one's pretty simple. Make sure your elbows are staying low and your rhythm is fluid. You wanna do eight reps here, three sets of eight. The fourth set's gonna be anywhere from 12 to 13 reps. You wanna focus on tension and getting that max volume in that last set to get that finishing pump. So right here, you're not gonna go inside or outside grip. It's kind of a smooth in between. Stick here, make sure your wrists, sorry, I have to get a good view here. You wanna make sure your wrists aren't necessarily bending. You can use wrist straps if you want, if the weight feels heavy. For now, I'm just gonna go free weight. So here, I'm gonna do eight reps. So, eight. Just normal curls. Come here, boom. Twist before you get to the top. Push back down to the hammer position at the bottom, just like this, for three sets of eight, fourth set, 12 to 13. So right now we're doing our push-ups. We're doing 20 reps of normal, 20 reps military, 20 reps ride, wide, three sets each. So three sets of military, so three sets normal of 20 reps. So right here, we'll go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So after you do three sets of that for the 20 reps of normal, you're gonna move over to military. You're gonna do 20 reps for three sets of military. And military is basically when you just go straight back, almost kind of rubbing your biceps against your lats there. So let's do 20 of these. That was two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Beautiful. So after the 20 reps, you do three sets of that again, like I said, and now you're gonna move over to wide. Wide is, like it says, just a wide stance, legs wide as well, like this. 20 reps again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So, I do those push-ups after every single workout, after every single day. So I do, I'm actually gonna be real with you. I don't do 20, I do 30. So I do 30 for three sets normal, 30 for three sets military, 30 for three sets wide. It equals, I'll tell you, I think 270 something push-ups. So I do that every single day, after every single workout, or before every single workout, or I space it. So I'll do my lifting in the morning, and my body weight later, or my body weight in the morning, my lifting weight. Sorry, I'm out of breath. So now, I do my ab routine. Ab routine's simple. I'm gonna show you right here. I sit here for a minute, and I hold, right? For here, for a full minute. Right after I finish holding, I move over to here. I do 100 oblique twists. You can do it with a ball. You can do it with free weight. Doesn't matter. Obviously, you can tell I do it with free weight, because I do 100 of them. Let me move over to here. Oh, there's so many different things to prop my camera up on today. It's kind of cool. And this one, you know, these dip bar Legs straight, bring them up. Just like that. I'll do 15 of those. So, minute hold with the leg raise. Minute hold with the leg raise. 100 oblique twists. We move over to here and we do 15 leg raises. That's one set. We do 3 sets of that. Now, including my push-ups, sorry. Now, as the same with my push-ups, I do those every day as well. So I do abs and push-ups every day no matter what. That was kind of leaving you guys behind. Okay, I just fell. That was kind of leaving you guys behind on exactly what I lift and how I lift. So I wanted to be fair and show you guys exactly what I'm doing every day with my specific routine. That right there was a full back and by routine day for me. That is how I go about it. And I don't always usually do it back to back. Like I said, sometimes I space it out. And I think that's more beneficial only because, I don't know, most people tend to gas out.